Tech Tips with Matt Rothman. We're here at the DC Microsoft office, and we just had a seminar on Office 2010, and I'm here with the two speakers, Ash Bonebrake and Judy Borsher, and I was hoping both of you could tell us some of the features about Office 2010 that you showcased today in the seminar.
Well, I kind of started off the session this morning and really focused on the social networking aspects of things as well as the collaboration features. So the new Outlook social connector, I have it linked into LinkedIn, and it allows you to have a lot of really good information about your contact and all the activities that they've done.
So your LinkedIn profile is going to be integrated with your Outlook?
Mine, as well as everybody else that I send email back and forth with. And so I can see all their activities that they do, all their meetings that they've scheduled, all their attachments. It's all right there.
So those LinkedIn users out there, if they go with Office 2010, they don't need to keep LinkedIn open every day?
Not at all. Right inside your Outlook where you are already.
Oh, that's a great feature. What about, say, a Facebook or a Twitter?
Twitter's not even in the works, but Facebook's supposed to be releasing here pretty soon.
Excellent.
But MySpace is available, and LiveSpaces will be available pretty soon, too.
Okay, and then you also mentioned collaboration. Tell us about, you know, what features of Office 2010 and collaboration, how that works.
There's a lot of features inside Outlook. I mean, the conversation view, so it's really easy to know who you're working with and doing what. As well as PowerPoint and the Office web apps, and the ability to do co-authoring is one of the real important ones. So you can literally work on the same document together at the same time and see each other's changes as you go.
Excellent. Well, thank you, Ash. Judy, what did you showcase in today's Office 2010 event?
Well, I think the attendees really enjoyed hearing about the Power Pivot feature, which is a new feature in Excel 2010, which lets you create pivot tables and new pivot charts based on huge amounts of data from a variety of data sources. PowerPoint was also very popular with the group today. A lot of people wanted to know about animation. Ash showed some fabulous animated slides, which you'll have to put up on your tech topics. They're great. And we also spent a lot of time in Outlook, talking about some of the new Outlook features for cleaning up old emails, sending media requests, responding to media requests, just a wide variety of features that were very popular.
So do you recommend Office 2010? If someone out there is using 2003 or 2007, you should be like, upgrade today.
It's unbelievable how much time you can save from all the little productivity features and new ribbon features. The ability to customize the ribbon is fabulous. It just answers a lot of questions that people have asked with the release of Office 2007. There's just so many new features here. Yes, I would encourage anybody to upgrade to Office 2010 as soon as possible.
So there you've heard it, Office 2010, some great new features available. Just hit the shelves and stores this past week. So you should definitely go out there and look at Office 2010. And this is Tech Tips with Matt Rothman.